नहीं करता हूँ, किसी को रिवीजन नहीं करता हूँ ये चैप्टर। टुडे विल सी रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस। यस्टरडे वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ऑस्मोसिस मींस जनरली व्हेन यू सेपरेट टू डिफरेंट कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड सॉल्यूशंस विथ अ सेमी परमेबल मेम्ब्रेन solvent will move from low concentration to high concentration. This phenomena you are calling as a osmosis. When solvent moves, ye concept important bit. When solvent moves from low concentration to high concentration, or solvent to solution side, through semi-permeable membrane. That process is called what? Osmosis. Now what is reverse osmosis? Now opposite, if solvent moves from high concentration to low concentration, from solution to solvent side, then that is called what? Reverse osmosis. Then this is the thing actually. What is happening here? Again you are taking what here? Semi-permeable membrane. This is a semi-permeable membrane. Now here you are having what? Solution. And here you are having solvent. Or otherwise you are having high concentration here. Low concentration you are having. In this case, in the reverse osmosis, now solvent will move from solution to solvent or high concentration to low concentration. This phenomena is called what? Reverse osmosis here. Now when it will takes place, whenever if you apply more than the osmotic pressure, if you apply more than the osmotic pressure on solution side, then only this process will takes place. Let me discuss with the diagrams and everything. As already told you, the direction of osmosis can be reversed. Actual osmosis is what? Dilute to concentration, isn't it? Solvent to solution, isn't it? Now actually what we are reversing? Dilute to concentration, or low concentration to high concentration, or solvent to solution. This flow is generally takes place in where? Osmosis. This we are reversing here. This phenomena we are reversing. How? By using a pressure which is higher than the osmotic pressure, isn't it? Where we are applying that pressure? On solution side. Then we are going to get the reverse osmosis. Generally this process is useful for the water purification. How? Let me see. By using this tank. Now this I have taken a fresh water. This is a fresh water. This one is a fresh water, pure water. This one is a salty water, saline water, impure water, salt water I have taken. And these two are separated by a semi-permeable membrane. Okay, the fresh water and salt water separated by semi-permeable membrane. Now where we have to apply the large pressure? On which side we have to apply? Solvent side or solution side? Fresh water side or salt water side? Tell me better.
Salt water, sir.
From solution side, otherwise salt one. From this side we are applying what here? Pressure. How much pressure we have to apply? More than the osmotic pressure. For example, if osmotic pressure is 2 atm pressure, apply 2.2 atmosphere pressure. Or here suddenly what happened? Reverse osmosis takes place. Now from here only water will move here. Only water will move here. Only water will. For suppose, just imagine it is actually sea water. This is a sea water beta. This one is a sea water. Okay, this is actually seawater, isn't it? This is a seawater. Now we have to make pure water from the seawater. You have to purify the seawater. You have to make the seawater into drinking purpose. How to make? By using the reverse osmosis. We are not using any type of chemicals for purification of water here. No chemicals are added here for purification. What we are using, we are separating by using a semi-permeable membrane. So I have taken in this red compartment, I have taken some salt water, which is sea water, saline water we have taken. Now how to purify this water, how to make this one into water. Now when you apply semi-permeable membrane at the middle compartment, apply more than the osmotic pressure, then only will, I told you already, through the semi-permeable membrane, only will water will move, but not the salt. So whatever the water which is having in the sea water, salty water, only water will come into the fresh water. Now this will have a residue of only salt. After some time, this will have residue of what? Some salt action. Until what happens? Osmotic pressure is equal, the flow will take place. Understood?
How excuse me, sir.
Bolo de.
Sir, while this process is going on, the total salts will be eliminated from the water or some salts will be there?
Dekho, see, you have to take, dekho. First of all, I have taken 1 liter of what pure water I have taken, because we are doing a small experiment. I have taken 1 liter water. Here you take 5 liters of water. Just imagine, you take what, 5 liters of water. Okay. Now when you separate semi-permeable membrane and apply some osmotic pressure more than what, this from this what happened, 2 liters of water will come here. Okay. 2 liters of water will come here. It become 3 liter. No, immediately you have to remove this water. Okay, whatever the pure water we have to remove, we have to decrease whatever the volume we get. Again, send some more water. This process will continuously taking place. Why? Because see, osmotic pressure definitely will be same. After some time, an equilibrium will be established in which whatever the osmotic pressure will be remains same. So what I'm saying here, whenever water is coming into this compartment, only water, salt is remaining here only. Whatever the salt will remain here only. Salt will not come into this compartment. Whatever the NaCl, whatever it may be, they will not come into this compartment. Why? Because this semi-permeable membrane does not allow the salt particles, allow only what? Solvent particles, because this hole can permits only water, because water is small in size. The salt is large in size. They can't come here. So only water will come here. So whenever you will get a water here, immediately remove that water. Open the tap here. If you open the tap, what happened? The water will come outside. So this process will take place continuously. The salt will remain here, but you are adding what happened? Some more salt water. After some time, you can remove the salt by just cleaning this everything. Everything you can clean and you can remove the salt. Salt will residue like this. It will residue like this. Understood? Any doubts you are having?
No, sir.
Now, what type of question you will get in examination? What is reverse osmosis? How water is purified in this process? Definition. The definition of either you are seeing, no, this definition you can write. The direction of osmosis can be reversed if a pressure larger than osmotic pressure is applied on solution side. This is called what? Reverse osmosis. A diagram thoda draw karke aap explain kar sakte. इसमें भी आपको यहाँ पिस्टन यूज करना है, तो यहाँ पर सॉल्ट वाटर, फ्रेश वाटर लेना है, और यू हैव टू शो द वाटर इज गोइंग फ्रॉम दिस साइड टू लेफ्ट साइड एक्चुअली, राइट? सो ऑलरेडी आई टोल्ड यू रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस जनरली यूजफुल फॉर डिसाल्टिनेशन ऑफ सी वाटर, टू रिमूव द सॉल्ट फ्रॉम द सी, वी कैन यूज दिस टाइप ऑफ प्रोसेस. Now the pressure we are using here definitely should be very high, because it should more than what? Osmotic pressure. Now generally what happens? The porous membrane, nothing but semi-permeable membrane, generally we have to use to separate what? Salt from the pure water here. Generally we'll take a cellulose acetate we are using for this point of. It over same application beta. Cellulose acetate permeable water is impermeable to impurities. Impurities nothing but what? Salts. Only solvent water will flow through this semi-permeable membrane. Cellulose acetate allows only solvent but not the impurities. And modern world, if you observe what happened, Gulf countries, because Gulf countries do not have the river water. So they are having plenty of what? Huge amount of what? Sea water is there. Surrounding is, everything is for Gulf countries if you go. They're having what? plenty of what watery resources are there, but they are what salty in nature. And they are using what desalination process by using reverse osmosis. They are converting the sea water into what pure water by using the this method called reverse osmosis. Understood better? Any doubts you are having? This what happened? I have completed the reverse osmosis, isn't it? This you need to remember for examination point of view. Read the textbook. Same points were given to observe. After the completion of the class, you need to read the textbook. Otherwise, what happened? It is waste. Even if you listen to the class, what happened? It not does not useful for you. Once if you read the textbook, what happened? 100% it will be, isn't it, useful for you the class. Otherwise, what happened? No need to listen to the class also. If you don't read the textbook, simply listening to what music like that. Now, next we will see the abnormal molar. This is the last topic in this chapter. Abnormal molar mass. Now, what is this abnormal molar mass? Generally, a normal molar mass will be there. What is the meaning of this abnormal molar mass? Now, for example, if I take an ionic compound like NaCl, if I take, listen all of you carefully here. I am taking NaCl compound, isn't it? I have taken NaCl compound. Now, generally, NaCl is ionic compound. Definitely dissociate in water as Na plus and Cl minus. Okay. Now I have dissolved in water. How many moles I have dissolved? 1 mole in water. 1 mole of NaCl I have dissolved in the water. Now after dissolve, how many moles I will get better? Before dissolving, it is 1 mole of NaCl. After dissolving, how many moles it will convert in water?
Sir, 1 mole Na plus and 1 mole Cl minus.
Now, total how many moles we get in water?
2, sir.
Very good. So actually the colligative properties depends upon the, isn't it, number of solute particles, but not the nature of solute. Yeah. It depends upon the nature of solvent. Remember, it depends upon the nature of the solvent, but it does not depend upon the nature of the solute. Depends upon how many moles you are adding. But you are thinking that you have added only 1 mole of NaCl, but in true what is happening, you have added 2 moles actually. Okay, before adding it is 1 mole only, but once if you add in the water, it is converting into how many moles here? 2 moles. Now this 2 moles is nothing but called abnormal molar mass, we can call, isn't it? This is for dissociation. Similarly, what happened, if you take what association also takes place. For example, you take beta. KCl, if you take. KCl molecular weight is 74.5. Correct? Potassium is 39 and Cl is what? 35.5, something like this. Isn't it? Now, if I take something here, what? 1 mole. If you add 1 mole of KCl, you are getting 1 mole of K plus. 1 mole of K plus and 1 mole of Cl minus is releasing into the solution. If this happens, there would be how many moles now you are getting? 2 moles you are going to get in the solution. This I am explaining here. Here only I have explained with NaCl. In the slide, you are going to see what here? KCl you are seeing actually. Right. So if you see this one, 1 mole of KCl in 1 kg of water would expect to increase the boiling point twice, 2 times it will increase, because you before addition it is 1 mole only, but we are doing calculation. Are many number of problems you have done? No, last day I have done some problems. How we done the problems better? How we have done the problems yesterday? Have you done any experiment for doing the problems yesterday? What we have done the problems? Osmotic pressure. We have done any experiment to the problems? Yes. Have you done any experiment better to solve these problems? Yes, Vedant. Vedant. Rohit? Omkar? Ramya?
Yes, sir.
Is my voice is audible or not?
Yes, sir.
The nobody is replying. Yesterday, how we done the problems? By doing experiment, otherwise normally we have done the problem.
Normally, sir.
देखो बेटा मैं कल से क्लास नहीं लेता हूँ, मैं किसी को आलो नहीं करता हूँ, मैं क्लास लेता हूँ, रिकॉर्ड भी नहीं करता हूँ, मैं बोलता हूँ चैप्टर कंप्लीट हुआ। ओनली आई विल टेक ओनली 10 मेंबर्स हु आर लिसनिंग टू द क्लास। मैं मेरे को पता है मैं डेली अटेंडेंस ले रहा हूँ, हाउ मनी ऑफ यू आर रिस्पॉन्डिंग, आई एम नोटिंग एवरीथिंग। तो कल से मैं एक काम करता हूँ, ओनली दैट people only I will take these classes, only for them only, for 10 to 15 are there, for them only I will take the class, remaining I don't allow to join the class. I know who are responding, I'm noting everything. Main itna time lekar aapko explain kar raha hu, main chahe to jaldi bhi complete kar sakta hu isko. If you don't respond, what happened? I will do one thing. I will select some students and I will take classes only for them only. And after the school starts, what happened? I don't remaining sit in the class. I don't allow them to sit in the class because they don't have any interest. जिसको मैं जिसका नाम मैं एक्चुअली पूछ रहा हूँ क्वेश्चंस, दे आर नॉट रिस्पॉन्डिंग मीन्स आई डोंट अलो देम फ्रॉम नेक्स्ट वीक ऑनवर्ड्स। मैं सिंपल क्वेश्चन पूछा आपसे, हाउ वी हैव डन द प्रॉब्लम्स, हमने एक्सपेरिमेंट किया नहीं किया, नहीं किया, दिस इज द क्वेश्चन आई एम आस्किंग, इज इट वॉट डिफिकल्ट टू आंसर, हाउ वी हैव डन द प्रॉब्लम्स विदाउट एनी एक्सपेरिमेंट, by using the theoretical methods, by using the formulas, theoretically we have done the problems, no experiment. This is the question from me. You are not responding. Yeah, Monday onwards I will select some students, only for them only I will take the class, remaining no need to join and no need to come to school after the June 20 also. See, today presentees are very less. एक काम करता हूँ मैं, two times call class लेता हूँ बेटा. One time only selected people I will explain the class in detail. For remaining what happened now? 40 members हैं, out of 55 में और 40 members हैं, उसको मैं आधा घंटे में class खत्म करता हूँ. पूरा पढ़ता हूँ मैं, simply मैं explain नहीं करता हूँ, simply पढ़ता हूँ मैं. और होमवर्क भी देता हूँ उन लोगों को, ज्यादा होमवर्क मैं देता हूँ उन लोगों को, और जो 15 मेंबर्स को सिलेक्ट करके मैं पढ़ाता हूँ ना, उन लोगों को मैं ही करता हूँ प्रॉब्लम, ज्यादा प्रॉब्लम मैं ही करता हूँ, उसको होमवर्क कम कर देता हूँ मैं, मंडे से ही काम करता हूँ बेटा. 9:30 to 10:30 एक क्लास लेता हूँ, 10:30 से 11 और एक क्लास लेता हूँ. 10:30 11 o'clock 40 मेंबर्स रहते, तो बाकी का 15 मेंबर्स वो रिस्पॉन्स होता है ना क्लास में, उन लोगों को लेता हूँ. दिस ओनली द सोल्यूशन फॉर मी. From Monday onwards, I will take the class in this way only. Now, if you observe here what happened, in this case, the boiling point, you got 5.52 theoretically. Critically, when you do the problem, you got this is the answer, you got 0.52. But when you do experiment, answer we are going to get, that is 1.04. Whatever the answer we are going to get, that is 1.04. Right? Why 1.04 you are getting experimentally? Because KCl dissociate into two ions, that means two moles are there. Into it is two moles. But we are, what we are thinking, KCl we have added only one mole. Therefore, the answer must be 0.52. But experimentally, what happened? This is converted into two moles, and the answer we are going to get, that is what? 1.04. This absolute value. The absolute value, how much here? 1.04. Critical value, how much we got here? 0.52. So this is the reason, whatever, whenever you are doing the calculation part is not comparing, you know, we cannot compare that with what experimental value. When you compare what happened, you are getting wrong results. So this is the thing, actually, the true value is what we are not getting when you do theoretically, isn't it? Experimental value and theoretical value is not getting matching here, isn't it? Now, for example, if what about the association? Only dissociation takes place? No, association also takes place. For example, if I take acetic acid called ethanoic acid, it will undergo association dimerases. That means two molecules will convert into one molecule in the benzene solution. Because you have taken solvent, I have taken benzene. What is the reason here? Because of what? Hydrogen bonding. Acetic acid can form hydrogen bonding like this. CH3, C double bond OH. Right, reversely, CH3, C double bond OOH. Now here, this is the first molecule, this is the second molecule. Between these two, hydrogen bonding is taking place here. Hydrogen bonding is taking place. Now this is now converting into single molecule. Now it is single molecule. Previously, it is how many molecules here? Previously, how many molecules are there here?
Two molecules
are there. Now it is converting into single molecule. Why? Because of hydrogen bonding, because of association, because of dimerization. Okay, now what we are thinking, I have added two moles. You are thinking that I have added two moles, but when you see the answer, isn't it? It is for one mole you are getting the answer. The answer we are going to get for how many moles are getting? One mole. Again, you are getting wrong result when you do theoretically. Experimentally, isn't it? You think that the answer must be something 1.2. But the answer, how much you are getting, beta? Reverse. How much you are getting? 0.6 something you are getting. Why? Because you are thinking that you are added two moles, but they are converting into one. Why? Because the colligative properties are depending upon how many moles of solute you are adding. But after adding the solute in the water or any solvent, they may undergo dissociation, they may undergo association, in which the number of moles may be increased, number of moles can be decreased. So this is the reason we are going to see the abnormal molar mass. We have to correct this value by using the Van Hoff factor. Similarly, even trimerization also can take place, isn't it? In which three molecules will give what? How many molecules? One molecule we are going to see, isn't it? Now, isn't it? If all molecules of acetic acid associates in benzene, then the molecular mass, for example, generally what happens, you see, the acetic acid molar mass, how much, beta? 60, actually. Correct or not? But because of association, if it is associated, the molar mass now becomes how much, beta? 120 you are going to get. The change in the molar mass of single molecule now will convert into 120. It is actually 60. But actually value you are going to get for one molecule, how much you are getting, beta? 120 molar mass. Right? So now let me see what happened. Because of this, what happened? The values are going to get half of the value. Already I told you how you are getting half of the value. Just now in the previous slide, explained this. Because of this, what happened? The molar mass may be lower or higher based upon the association and dissociation. Okay? Right. This is not very important for us. Now, let me see what happened. To explain this abnormal mass here, which may be lower value or higher value, we are going to get, Van't Hoff proposed a value called I value, I factor they have proposed here. to explain the dissociation association to match the experimental and theoretical value, he proposed what I value. I is nothing but 1/2 factor here. So how it works, I value, how it works, I is generally is equal to normal molar mass divided by abnormal molar mass. For example, acetic acid, just example, we'll take acetic acid. This is single, when undergo dimerization, CH3COOH becomes dimerization like this. Now what is the normal molar mass beta to calculate I value here? Isn't it? What's the normal molar mass for acetic acid?
60, sir.
Very good. Abnormal molar mass is how much beta?
120.
Now I value is equal to what here? 0.5. Now whatever the values we are going to, for example, if I get elevation of boiling point, if I get something 0.6, isn't it? Actual value should be how much beta? 0.3. Because this much, half of the value you are going to get. So I value is nothing but normal molar mass by abnormal molar mass. For example, if you don't have the molar mass, what property you have to take? Observed colligative property by calculated. For example, somebody have done the experiment. You have calculated the boiling point. The boiling point, you got something 273.15 you got. Okay, just something. I'm taking the value like this. 374 you have got, observed value, experimental value. Somebody have done the experiment, this value you got. Theoretical value, I got something what? 376.15. This is a theoretical value I got. Now when you substitute the experimental value and theoretical value, definitely that will give I value. In this way also we can calculate the I value very easily. All these formulas are there in the textbook. If you observe your textbook, they're given like this. Next, one more formula also we can give. Total number of moles particles after dissociation, before dissociation. For example, if I take what happened, NaCl I have taken. Na plus Cl minus. Before dissociation, there is one. After dissociation, how many moles you are having? 2 moles. So like that also, we can easily calculate the I value. But it looks very simple, but what happens, you know, most of the questions what happened, the salts do not undergo complete dissociation. Whatever the solutes I'm saying, the solutes do not undergo complete dissociation. In that case, you cannot take exactly 2. For example, there are 100 molecules are there. You don't take NaCl, you take something acetic acid is there. Simple acetic acid. If it is dissociating, what happens? You can't say always acetic acid dissociate. Sometimes it may undergo dissociation, sometimes it may undergo association, depend upon the solvent. If I take benzene as a solvent, it will undergo association. If I take water as a solvent, acetic acid undergo dissociation. Depend upon the solvent, it will undergo like that. Understood better. For example, if I take acetic acid, 100 molecules, if I take out of 100, only 5 are dissociating. Only are 5 are dissociating. In that case, you can't take what 100 or 100 moles, I will get 100 moles of Na plus, 100 moles of acetic acid, and 100 moles of H plus. I can't say like that. Because if it is partially ionizing, understood my point better. CH3COOH dissociating into CH3COO minus and H plus. If you have 100 molecules are there, if all are having ionization, how many we get actually? 200 moles we get. But what I'm saying, only 5% is dissociating, if I say. How much we get beta? Only here, wait here, 5, we get 5. Only 10 moles we are going to get. Only 10 moles we are going to get. Understood? So this, how much dissociation is taking place, how much association is taking place, that is important. That is the reason what happened. These problems will lead to what? Many number of steps. We don't get directly. If it's 100% dissociation, the problem is very simple for us. We can do easily. I will show how we are doing that problem also. With 100% dissociation and partial dissociation, 100% dissociation problems are very simple. Partial dissociation problems are getting what? Very difficult to do this. I will show that one how to do the problems. Now, see. Now how the formula, now there are 4 colligative properties are there better. First colligative property without I, there is no I actually. See, this is the first formula. P naught minus P by P naught is equal to mole fraction of solute, correct? Now in every case, we multiply with I. Wherever formula is there, multiply with I. You have multiplied with I. Now take the second formula, I have multiplied with I. Take the third formula, multiply with I. take the fourth formula, multiply with that. That means all the formulas now we are multiplying with I. Then we get experimental value and critical value, both will get same actually. Understood? For example, how to make both experimental value and critical value same? Just multiply I value with the result. Critical value got something 20.2. Multiply this one with I, now this become experimental value will be same, isn't it? So now whenever if they ask the problems, no? Now take these formulas, no? Take this type of formulas, whatever the formulas you are modifying, just by multiplying it what I value here, right? Now here how to do the problems. Now first of all, I have taken for dissociation, but I have taken dissociation. Okay, if I take a molecule n times, it is dissociating. Initially there is only one molecule is there, you take one mole is there, take zero moles after without dissociation, before it is a zero moles because experiment is not started. After dissociation, alpha amount is dissociated, alpha amount is found. Okay, now multiply this one with n, because how many molecules you have dissociated, that is the reason I multiplied with n. Actually alpha is nothing but degree of dissociation, how much dissociation is took place actually. But the total number of molecules after the dissociation, how many molecules you are having, how to calculate the total number of moles after dissociation, you have to add these two better. Add these two to calculate total number of moles after the dissociation. How do we calculate better? Very simple. Add at this after dissociation, how many are there? 1 minus alpha plus n alpha. Add this one, 1 minus alpha plus n alpha. So if you do this one, you are going to get 1 plus n minus alpha. Rearrangement this one, isn't it? You will get 1 like this. 1 plus n alpha minus alpha. Take what? 1 plus alpha, take common, you will get n minus 1. So this one you have written directly. I have taken directly. Don't get confused. By using this one, I have taken this formula. Now what is total number of moles after dissociation? 1 plus alpha into n minus 1. This is the formula, isn't it? To calculate what? Total number of moles after dissociation, right? Next, total number of moles present before dissociation, how many are there? How many are there beta? Total number of moles particles before dissociation, ye kitna ho jayega? How many are there?
One.
Only one, right? This one, very good. Now here kya lena hai aapko? Total number of moles ye lena hai. Now what will be the formula for I? I is equal to 1 plus alpha into n minus 1 divided by 1. Yeah, I got it. Is equal to 1 plus n minus 1 into alpha divided. This is after dissociation, this is before dissociation. Now I is equal to a formula. I is equal to aapko aayega, I is equal to 1 plus n minus 1 alpha. Alpha ko kaise calculate karna hai? Now n minus 1 into alpha is equal to I minus 1. Shall I write like this? Now alpha is equal to I minus 1 n minus 1. You have to remember this formula for what? Kaha use karna hai formula? I minus 1 n minus 1 for dissociation or ionization. Okay, in examination they are asking degree of dissociation or ionization. If they given I values and n values, which formula we have to use? This formula. All of you know this formula better. I minus 1 n minus, this will work for what? Dissociation only. Okay, there are number of problems are there to calculate the degree of dissociation. Very lengthy problems there, but very simple if you know this formula. I minus 1 n minus 1, this is a derivation I have done to get this one, right? If you don't understand, watch the video again, because it is recorded. Watch this one and how you are getting this formula, how you are getting this derivation of the formula, you practice this, right? Next we go for lastly association. Now when you have association, how you take the formula? Same, initially it is 1 mole, it is 0 moles. After association, if alpha amount is associating, we get alpha by n here, because it is associating, no, take alpha by n here. Now where alpha is degree of association, in previous case it is degree of dissociation, now it is association. Now what happens here? Total number of moles of after the association. Kya karna hai aapko after association? Ye dono ko add karna hai. Total number of moles of after association dono ko add karna hai. To kitna ho jayega aapko? Ye ho jayega. 1 माइनस अल्फा प्लस अल्फा बाय एन, थोड़ा रीअरेंज करने के बाद ये अल्फा को कॉमन करने के बाद आपको ए आएगा. इफ यू टेक व्हाट 1 प्लस अल्फा बाय एन माइनस अल्फा टेक प्लस अल्फा कॉमन ले लो 1 माइनस 1, ये आपको आएगा, ये फॉर्मूला आएगा. इट्स वेरी सिंपल, व्हेन यू डू लाइक दिस इट विल गेट लाइक दिस. नाउ फ्रॉम दिस व्हाट हैपेंड, यू गॉट नंबर ऑफ मोल्स आफ्टर डिसोसिएशन. अगेन द फॉर्मूला इज आफ्टर डिसोसिएशन बाय बिफोर डिसोसिएशन. After dissociation कितना लेना है आपको, ये formula 1 plus 1 by n minus 1 into alpha. Before dissociation always will be 1 only. So after this I is equal to how much you are getting, this one you are getting. So again rearrange this one. Finally if you do this one, we are getting this formula. This formula you are getting. I minus by 1 minus n minus. That means what is the difference you are observing? I minus 1, n minus 1. This is for dissociation. This is for dissociation. Now if I take I minus 1, 1 by n minus 1, isn't it? This is for what? Association. Okay? If you take 1 by n minus 1, association. N minus 1, dissociation. Now, these are the formulas you have to remember. Understood? I minus 1, n minus 1 for dissociation. 1 by n minus 1 for association. I minus 1 is common for both the cases. So, note down these formulas which are very, very important. I will take small problem beta. Simple problem. A dilute solution of A of concentration C you showed on osmotic pressure, which is higher in value, that is calculated from the pi is equal to CRT. So, Joe, what does it indicate about the nature of the solute? You have to say it is dissociated or not. See, the value you got, a dilute solution of A of concentrated C show an osmotic pressure which is higher in value, that is calculated. That means experimental value, isn't it? The experimental value is what? Greater than, isn't it? Theoretical value. When it is undergo dissociation. Isn't it? If it undergo dissociation, what happened? This type of dissociation or ionization, both are what? Same. When you get lesser value, pi experimental value will be lesser. Tell me better. When this value will be lesser?
On association.
Association, isn't it? Now, one more question. Between NaCl and barium chloride of same concentration, the I factor will be more. Here, both are completely dissociated. Remember, they are completely dissociating. Just assume it is completely dissociated. Now, which will have I value more beta? Which case I value is more?
BaCl2.
BaCl, because it will form three ions, it will form three moles. Definitely I factor will be more for this one, right? So very simple. So if you observe what happened for barium chloride, N is equal to 3 because there are three ions are produced here, where for NaCl, N is equal to 2. When you substitute in the formula, isn't it? You are getting here 3, you are getting here 2, isn't it? This is very simple formulas for us. Now, I will do some problems better. We'll do some problems here. We'll take a formula here. All right. At least these are the formulas, problems we can do now. 2.4. Now, what we have to calculate here? See here. What they are asking here, determine the amount of calcium chloride. Weight of calcium chloride, nothing but it is weight of the solute. How much we have to calculate? Ye calculate karna hai. I value they given 2.47, and volume of the solvent is given 2.5 liter. You read this question, but all have to read this one. Determine the amount of calcium chloride. I is equal to 2.47 dissolved in 2.5 liter of water, such that osmotic pressure pi is equal to 0.75 atm and temperature is given how much beta? 300 Kelvin temperature, because 27 plus how much you have to take? 273, that equal to 300. Now what is the formula for calculation of osmotic pressure? Tell me. What is the formula?
CRT.
CRT is correct formula? Is it correct formula?
NCRT.
What I told you just now? मैंने क्या बोला आपको just now? क्या बोला मैंने आपको?
I
तो multiply करना है. Whatever the formula we are taking, that we'll have to multiply with I. देखो ऑल फॉर्मुलास आर मल्टीप्लाइड विद आई, करेक्ट आर नॉट? दिस थिंग यू आर ऑब्जर्व, ऑल फॉर्मुलास आर मल्टीप्लाइड विद आई, आई विदाउट आई यू कैन नॉट टेक नो, राइट? नाउ टेल मी, कैन आई टेक आई वैल्यू फॉर ग्लूकोज? इट पॉसिबल? कैन आई टेक ग्लूकोज, सुक्रोज, यूरिया फॉर दिस वन? नो आई वैल्यू. वाई? फॉर ग्लूकोज, सुक्रोज, यूरिया we are not taking I value. Why? Anybody? Why we are not?
After.
Yes?
Sir, they do not undergo dissociation or association.
Very good. Whatever the problems you are done, if you observe it, they are, the solutes are non-volatile solutes which are does not undergo dissociation association. For example, you see whether you have done which we see the problems, whatever the problems you have done, you have completed. Let me see that problems first of all. Which problems you have done? Dekho, yahan par maine sugar liya. Sugar liya maine. Sugar does not undergo dissociation. I value ke lene ki zarurat nahi hai. Glucose liya humne idhar, isn't it? Glucose ke liye, is problem ke liye I value lene ki zarurat hi nahi hai. We have done this problem, correct? Here, you also, we have done this problem also. Octane. Octane also does not undergo any type of dissociation association. So, humne problem kiya, whatever the problems are actually based on solutes which are do not undergo dissociation and association. You see some more problems also here. Because you need to understand which solute undergo dissociation, which solute does not undergo dissociation. You see, this one is what? Polymer. Polymer never undergo dissociation association. Yahan par humne urea liya. This is what urea. Urea will never undergo. Sucrose liya humne. Vitamin C liya humne. Isn't it? So wherever we have done the problems, they are without I values. Why? Because they undergo no dissociation, no association. Now what problems we are doing here? That problems are actually based upon I values. See? Now we are doing this problem. This is compulsory or take I value. Why? Because K2SO4, they are saying here, K2SO4. K2SO4 definitely undergo dissociation. Kaise hota hai K2SO4 dissociation? 2 moles of K plus and 1 mole of SO4 minus 2. So definitely 1 mole is converting into how many moles beta? 3 moles. 1 mole converting into how many moles? 3 moles. That is the reason you have to, they given I value also. They calculate the I value they given here. Now what will be the formula? Pi V is equal to nRT. What is the formula actually? Pi V is equal to nRT. This is the formula actually. Pi V is equal to nRT formula. Okay. Now this can be written as n by V into RT. Now this can be written as what? N is equal to weight by molar mass. Pi is equal to, where n is equal to what? Weight by molar mass. Now weight of the solute divided by molar mass of the solute into RT by V. Now I have to multiply this one with I because this is ionic compound. Because it is ionic compound, compulsory for ionic compounds multiply with I. So this is the formula for us. This is the formula. Okay. Now in the place of N, I have taken weight by molar mass. I have taken, this is the formula. Now pi is equal to kya beta yahan par kitna diya? 0.75. Now we are calculating weight of the solute. Molar mass of the solute diya. Molar mass of the solute aapko calculate karna hai beta. K2SO4 ka molar mass karna hai. Potassium ka kitna hai beta? 39. 39 into 2 lena hai because K2SO4. Kitna lena hai aapko? 78 lena hai because there are two potassiums out there. K2SO4 sulfur kitna hai? 32. Oxygen 16, but multiply this one with 4 because 4 oxygens are there. 6 4 is 24, 4 into 1 64 are. So multiply, add everything, 64, 32 and 78. Itna are aapko 14, 8, 11, 17, 174 are. So 174 yahan par lena hai. Hai na, correct hai na? 8 2 plus 10, 14, 8, 8 plus 3, 11. 11 plus 6, 74 into R value kitna lena hai par? 0.083 le lo. If you take 83, you will get answer in terms of bar like that. Into temperature 300, volume 2.5 liter and I value 2.47. Now, ये सब्स्टिट्यूट करो, वी विल गेट आंसर. ये सॉल्व करो बेटा, लाइक दिस यू विल गेट द आंसर. राइट? एनी डाउट्स यू आर हैविंग इन दिस प्रॉब्लम? आर यू हैविंग एनी डाउट्स इन दिस प्रॉब्लम?
नो सर.
नाउ यू हैव टू डू नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम. नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम आपको करना है, सेम टाइप ऑफ प्रॉब्लम. हमने ये किया, क्या किया बेटा, हमने ये किया शायद ना, हमने 2.40 कर रहे हैं ना शायद. ओके सॉरी सर, हमने 2.40
दोनों क्वेश्चंस के वैल्यूज ले लिया.
हां मैं, हमने ये लिया, हमने मोलर मास, मैंने हमने केडीएस फोर को लिया. एक काम करेंगे बेटा, यहां पर चेंज करेंगे, नो प्रॉब्लम, वी कैन चेंज हियर. यहां पर हमने इसमें तो विजिबिलिटी यही है, तो हमने यही लिया. एक काम करेंगे, कैल्शियम क्लोराइड का ले लेंगे. दिस वी डोंट टेक मोलर मास, कैल्शियम क्लोराइड का ले. एक K2SO4 का नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम में ले लो. यू आर नॉट सेइंग एनीथिंग आफ्टर कंप्लीशन. यू आर सेइंग यू कीप ए टेक्स्ट बुक विथ यू. तो क्या लेना आपको यहां पर, कैल्शियम क्लोराइड का कितना हो जाएगा, 111 हो जाएगा बेटा, बिकॉज इट इज वेरी इजी टू रिमेंबर. कैल्शियम का कितना 40, दो क्लोरीन का कितना हो जाएगा 71, तो आपको 111 हो जाएगा. यहां पर आपको क्या लेना है बेटा, 111 लेना है. 111 ले लो, आपको आंसर आएगा. ठीक है ना. सेकेंड वन, लेट्स नेक्स्ट वन, यू कैन डू दिस प्रॉब्लम, यू कैन डू ये, आपको कर, ये कर सकते आप ये प्रॉब्लम. Five value they are asking you. So same type of problem, isn't it? You can do this. यहाँ पर एक चीज you have to ध्यान देना आपको. You see, this is given 25 milligrams. आपको कैसे लेना है, ग्राम में लेना है. 25 into 10 to the power of minus 3 grams. ऐसा लेने आप. It will now convert into 0.025 grams. Take in terms of grams. ये वैल्यूम 2 liters ले सकते. Temperature को convert into 298 Kelvin temperature. Okay, so you can do this problem, right? Next, this is homework for you. This is homework for you. One more problem I will do, after that I will close now. One more problem is there, we'll do that one also. This one, 2.32. मैं ये करता हूं, मैं बाकी का दो एग्जाम्पल सॉल्व प्रॉब्लम आपको देता हूं. कैलकुलेट द डिप्रेशन इन द फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट ऑफ वाटर व्हेन 10 ग्राम्स ऑफ क्लोरो 1-2-3 ब्यूटेनोइक एसिड इज एडेड टू 250 ग्राम्स ऑफ वाटर वेयर Ka इज गिवन, Kf इज गिवन. यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द डिप्रेशन इन द फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट. आपको कैलकुलेट करना है, स्लाइड में ले लेंगे. डिप्रेशन इन द फ्रीजिंग न्यू स्लाइड ले लेंगे. प्रॉब्लम क्या है बेटा, इसके आपको डिप्रेशन फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट आपको कैलकुलेट करना है. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल मास ऑफ सोल्यूट कितना है बेटा, मास ऑफ द सोल्यूट डब्ल्यू बी कितना है बेटा इसमें,
10 grams.
टेक इट 10 grams. नेक्स्ट वाटर कितना है सॉल्वेंट, वेट ऑफ द
सॉल्यूशन
250 grams दिया. ओके नेक्स्ट मास ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन कितना हो जाएगा, मास ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन दोनों को मिलकर कितना हो जाएगा, 260 ग्राम्स हो रहा है मास ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन हो रहा है. नाउ व्हाट दे गिवन हियर, डेंसिटी इज गिवन. डेंसिटी क्योंकि हमको इसमें वेट नहीं दिया ना, जनरल डायरेक्टिव वैल्यूम नहीं दिया ना, इसमें वैल्यूम कैलकुलेट करना है ना इसमें, तो इसके वजह से मैं क्या करता हूँ, डेंसिटी का फॉर्मुला है. क्या है बेटा डेंसिटी का फॉर्मुला, मास बाय वैल्यू. और डेंसिटी कितना दिया इसने, 0.904 दिया. नेक्स्ट मास ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन कितना हो जाएगा, 260 ग्राम्स. नाउ वैल्यूम ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन आपको कैलकुलेट करना है. नाउ वैल्यूम ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन क्या हो जाएगा, वैल्यूम ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन इज इक्वल टू 260/0.904, ऑलमोस्ट 250 ऐसा हो जाएगा ना. कितना हो जाएगा ये देख बेट बट, 260/0.904 कितना हो रहा है बेटा, 260 डिवाइडेड बाय 0.904 कितना हो रहा है, 287 हो रहा है. यू आर नॉट डूइंग 287 हो रहा है. दिस इज द वैल्यूम यू गॉट एक्चुअली. नाउ व्हाट यू आर डूइंग हियर, आई वांट टू कैलकुलेट द इजंट इट डिप्रेशन द फ्रीजिंग पॉइंट. इसमें इसने डिसोसिएशन कांस्टेंट दिया. सो देखो बेटा डिप्रेशन ये तो कंपलसरी व्हाट हैपेंड डिसोसिएट हो रहा है क्योंकि यू आर डिसोसिएशन कांस्टेंट के ये दिया मींस व्हाट इट इज डिसोसिएट. तो आई वैल्यू कैलकुलेट करना है आपको. It is a dissociation they are saying. Ka dia. Ka means what? Dissociation constant. Means what? The whatever the solute we are going to here, see here, that is what? Dissociating. So I value compulsory aapko calculate karna hai. To calculate what here? Depression fizzing point. I value karne ke liye aapko alpha chahiye. Isn't it? But to getting that alpha, what happened? We need to calculate the concentration. Beta, ek formula hai. First year, 11th class mein aapne padha. Alpha is equal to ek formula hai. Can you recollect that formula? How to calculate alpha value? 11th class. Acid basis, we calculate a formula. Simple formula we have derived. Anybody remember that one? Alpha is equal to root Ka by C. This is the formula we have derived in the 11th class to calculate the degree of dissociation. Root Ka by C. K is given in the form problem. K kitna diya beta? Ka kitna diya?
1.4 into 10 to the power of minus.
Concentration is not given. Correct? Concentration is equal to what actually? Molarity. Now molarity bhi nahi diya. Toh molarity ka formula kya hai beta? Weight of the solute by molar mass of the solute into 1000 by volume of the solution in ml. Now, le lenge. Weight of the solute kitna hai beta? 10 grams. 10 grams hai. मोलर मास ऑफ द सॉल्यूट आपको कैलकुलेट करना है. ये फार्मूला देखो CH3 क्या दिया बेटा, बोलो एक बार. CH3 CH2 CH क्लोरीन दिया ना?
यस सर.
क्लोरीन दिया?
यस सर क्लोरीन.
हाँ नेक्स्ट व्हाट एसिड क्या है? एसिड नो COH. इसका मोलर मास कैलकुलेट करो एक बार. हाउ मेनी कार्बन आर देयर? 1 2 3 4. 12 4 जा 48. Next, how many oxygens are there here? 2 oxygens, 32. 1 chlorine is there, 35.5. Remaining are hydrogens, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Add करो कितना आ रहा है आपको? 8 plus 2 10, 15, 15 plus 7, 22, 12.5. Okay, 2 ले लेंगे हम. Here it is. Just a minute. 10, 15, 22. 7, 10, 122.5 आ रहा है. Correct or not? 122.5. यहाँ पर आपको कितना लेना है? 122.5 into 1000 by. Volume कितना है आपको? 287 ml आया. Take 287 ml. Now, what will be the molarity? Now, calculate करो एक बार. 10 into 1000. All of you do calculation. Kitna aa raha hai? 0.28. 0.28 we are getting. This is concentration. Nothing but molarity. Now how to calculate alpha value? Alpha kaise calculate karna hai aapko? Alpha is equal to, what formula is what? Root Ka by C. Now, Ka is equal to what? 1.4 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Concentration kitna hai abhi aapko? Humne calculate kiya, point. Kitna hai answer aapko? Concentration, 0.2?
0.28 sir.
0.284 आई थिंक 0.284. इसको करना है आपको. एक काम करेंगे, इसको करने के लिए हम एक काम करेंगे, रूट 14 ले लेंगे इसको, और इसको ले लेंगे 10 टू द पावर ऑफ माइनस 4 ले लेंगे, और ये क्या ले लेंगे 2.2 8 इंटू एक काम करेंगे बेटा सेम रखो कुछ नहीं करना है आपको 1.4 इंटू 10 टू द पावर ऑफ माइनस 3 ले लो और इसको 284 इंटू 10 टू द पावर ऑफ माइनस 3 ले लो दोनों कैंसिल हो जाएगा और बाकी का कितना हो जाएगा 1.4 बाय 284 एक काम करेंगे इसको तो सॉल्व करेंगे 1.4 10 टू द पावर ऑफ 14 इंटू 10 टू माइनस 1 हो जाएगा इसको नहीं कर सकते एक काम करेंगे इधर 28 बाय एक काम करेंगे विल डू वन थिंग यार यू विल टेक दिस वन 14 इंटू 10 टू द पावर ऑफ माइनस 4 ओनली एंड दिस वन विल टेक 28.4 इंटू 10 टू द पावर ऑफ माइनस 2 ऐसा ले लेंगे नाउ माइनस 2 गेट कैंसल तो आपको हो जाएगा रूट 14 बाय 28.4 10 टू द पावर माइनस 2 रूट इज इक्वल टू 10 टू द पावर माइनस 1 ये अलग हो जाएगा और इसको कैलकुलेट करना है रूट 14 बाय 28.4 आपको 14 बाय 28.4 करो बेटा 14 बाय 28.4 करे तो आपको आएगा 14 डिवाइड बाय 28.4 दैट इक्वल टू यू आर गोइंग टू गेट 0.5 रफली रूट 0.5 आर गेटिंग इनटू 10 टू द पावर ऑफ माइनस 1 इसका रूट कैलकुलेट करना है आपको रूट करने के बाद आपको रूट करने के बाद रूट 0.5 रफली यू आर गोइंग टू गेट 0.7 यू आर गोइंग टू गेट 0.7 इंटू 10 टू द पावर ऑफ माइनस 1 दैट इज इक्वल टू 0.07 नाउ अल्फा इज इक्वल टू कितना आ रहा है आपको 0.07 नाउ यू गॉट अल्फा वैल्यू राइट नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस वॉन्ट हैव फैक्ट अल्फा इज इक्वल टू क्या हो जाएगा बेटा alpha is equal to what is the formula you got tell me anybody what is the formula alpha is equal this for dissociation just now we discussed alpha is equal to formula anybody alpha formula I minus 1 by
n minus 1
yaad nahi rehte aapko I is equal to I minus 1 N minus alpha कितना है आपको 0.07 सब्स्टिट्यूट करो इधर I वैल्यू आपको कैलकुलेट करना है N देखो एसिड है ना बेटा मैं ऐसा लिख रहा हूं बेटा CH3 CH2 CH क्लोरो COOH डिसोसिएशन करने के बाद कैसे आएगा ये CH3 CH2 CHCl COO minus plus H plus. How many ions you are getting, beta? How many ions you are getting here?
Two, sir.
Two only. Here one. Two ions. 2 minus 1. That equal to 0.07 is equal to I minus 1. Now, I is equal to kya ho jayega? 1 plus 0.07. That is equal to 1.07. This will be I value. But what they are asking, I value? What they are asking, I value they are asking? What they are asking in the problem? Calculate the depression in the freezing point. Depression in the freezing point formula likho abhi. What is the depression in freezing point? Delta Tf is equal to Kf into molality into I. I lena hai compulsory aapko. Kf kitna diya beta? Ek bar dekho Kf kitna diya? Kf of the solvent कितना
1.86
ले लो ऐसा molality आपको calculate करना है molality is equal to again weight of the solute by molar mass of the solute into 1000 by weight of the solvent देखो weight of the solute बोला बेटा मेरे को I think 10 grams है ना
yes sir
yes
है ना यहाँ पर देखो weight of the 10 grams है solvent कितना है 250 grams molar mass कितना लिया हमने 122.5 ये याद रखो एक बार 122.5 10 ग्राम्स 250 देखो वेट ऑफ सॉल्यूट 10 ग्राम्स मोलर मास 122.5 इनटू 1000 बाय वेट ऑफ सॉल्वेंट कितना है बेटा
250
है ना राइट तो इसको करो मोलारिटी कितना आएगा आपको थाउजेंड divided by 122.5 divided by 250. You are going to get something 0.326. Is it correct, beta? 0.326 आ रहा है आपको?
Yes, sir.
I value कितना आ गया अभी आपको?
1.07
right? So तीनों को multiply करो, आपको answer आएगा. तीनों को multiply करो. 1.86 into 0.326 into 1.07. 0.648 RM beta. 0.648 RM. This is what depression phasing point. Very lengthy problem. Very, very lengthy problem. See how many steps we are done. You see, we have calculated first of all volume of the solution. Why? To calculate the concentration. If we calculate the concentration, substituting the formula, we get alpha value. Alpha value हमने क्यों calculate किया बेटा? I value calculate करने के लिए. To calculate the I value, we have taken the this formula. बाद में ये formula लिया alpha का formula. We got I value और I value हमने कहाँ पर substitute किया? Yes, substitute. These steps we are done here. So same type of problem is there. I think next problem also same type of problem. यहाँ देखो ये प्रॉब्लम है, सेम टाइप ऑफ प्रॉब्लम. कैलकुलेट द वन हाफ फैक्टर डिसोसिएशन कांस्टेंट के ए दे आर आस्किंग. डिसोसिएशन कांस्टेंट के ए एंड आई वैल्यू दे आर आस्किंग एंड एवरीथिंग दे आर गिवन. दिस इज होमवर्क फॉर यू. इट विल डिफिकल्ट ओनली बट यू हैव टू डू दिस प्रॉब्लम. अदरवाइज व्हाट हैपन, यू डोंट गेट एनीथिंग. इफ यू सिंपली लिसन टू द क्लास, इट विल नॉट रिमेंबर फॉर यू. इफ यू डू द प्रॉब्लम्स, द फॉर्मुलास विल बी ईजी फॉर यू. और कुछ प्रॉब्लम्स है बेटा, आई विल शो दैट फ्रॉम प्रॉब्लम्स. दिस दिस इज ऑलरेडी सॉल्व प्रॉब्लम्स. एक बार ये प्रैक्टिस करो. इफ यू प्रैक्टिस दिस प्रॉब्लम्स, डेफिनेटली दैट होमवर्क प्रॉब्लम, एक्सरसाइज प्रॉब्लम आल्सो यू कैन डू. दिस आर द प्रॉब्लम्स. इजंट इट सेम थिंग? एक्चुअली वी हैव डन हियर. वी हैव सी मोलारिटी कैलकुलेट किया, इजंट आई वैल्यू कैलकुलेट किया. सो एक बार देखो ये प्रॉब्लम्स, थोड़ा इसमें थोड़ा ध्यान दे दो प्रॉब्लम्स को. ओके, 1.2.13 एंड 2. This one, 1-2 problem. ये problems आपका homework है. Lengthy problems are there because there are 5 marks questions. All these questions are how many? 5 marks questions. You will get 5 marks if you solve this type of problems. Right? With this, what happened? We have completed this chapter, solution chapter. Next class, we'll see the doubts and again what topics we have discussed in the solution chapter. Total revision we'll do in the next class. For next class is only for what? Total revision, right? Now all of you read today. कहाँ से कहाँ तक पढ़ना है आपको? यहाँ से. Abnormal molar mass. यहाँ से पूरा आपको एक बार पढ़ना है. देखो हमने KCL का डिस्कस किया. अभी आप टेक्स्ट बुक पढ़े तो आपको आसान हो जाएगा. It's very simple. ये भी association डिस्कस किया. ये तीनों formulas भी डिस्कस किया हमने. Isn't it? And how we are multiplying I with all formulas. ये भी हमने discuss किया. Won't have factors. Problem. ये problem मैंने already discuss किया. But with a different data. Right? Any doubts you're having?
No, sir.
Today very few students are there. The topic is very important topic, but only few students are there today. 26.
Excuse me, sir.
Bolo, jaldi bolo.
Sir, tomorrow we will be having classes.
No class tomorrow. Sunday, no. Tomorrow, no class. We'll have class on Monday.
Okay, sir.
Abhishek Sharma, Anshu Yadav, Apurva Patil, Atharva, Ayush, Danshri, Gulabi, Kalpesh, Kaushal, Krunal, Omkar PC, समीक्षा, प्रथमेश, राहुल, रमिया, रिया, रोहित, सपना, शशिधर, श्रीहरि, स्नेहा जी, सोनाली के, सुमित यम, सुमित एसडी, वेदांत एंड यश. ओनली दीज स्टूडेंट्स हैव लिसन टुडेज क्लास. प्रेजेंट इज ऑफ टुडेज क्लास. ओके बेटा, यू कैन लीव नाउ.
थैंक यू सर.
थैंक यू सर.